welcome. I want to take this opportunity to welcome all of you to St. Michael's here in Richville. This is the 17th year that we are putting on our Passion Drama. And I want to tell you that all of the scenes are biblically correct and graphically portrayed. We are going to be following the footsteps of Jesus on his last day before he was crucified. I want to warn all of you to be as quiet as possible and to turn off your microphones or turn off your cell phones like you would if you're going to the movies. And we are going to be staying on the sidewalk. It's dried up some, but stay as much as you can on the walkway. We'll begin at the Garden of Gethsemane and proceed to the tomb where Jesus' dead body was laid to rest. We'll be on this tour for about 20 minutes, 25 at the most, so it just gives you an idea. Follow me as we go to the Garden of Gethsemane.
After Jesus had eaten the Passover meal with his disciples, he went with them to a place called Gethsemane.
How much farther, Lord? It's been a long journey. I'm sure I'm getting tired.
Sit here while I go over there to pray. And pray with me that you do not fall into temptation.
I'll try, Lord. You can count on us.
We're right here with
you.
Don't worry about us. Going a little further, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed.
My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will.
An angel appeared from heaven to strengthen him. Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping.
Why are you men sleeping? Could you not keep watch with me for 1 hour?
You must have built up.
Sorry, Lord. We were so tired.
Let you down, Lord. Sorry.
It'll never happen again.
It is no different today for us as Jesus followers. We have good intentions, but miss opportunities because of other concerns in our lives. In time of trial, we may be caught unprepared, as were the disciples.
Come on, man. Keep up.
Judas, which one is Jesus?
That's Judas?
Who are Rabbi? These people?
Judas, you betrayed the Son of Man with a kiss?
Are you Jesus?
I am. And if I am the one you seek, let these disciples go.
Back with you.
Let them go.
Back. Stop.
Then the disciples ran away, the soldiers arrested Jesus, and took him before the high priest.
Away with them.
Get him back!
Judas!
What are
you doing? Where is
this guy? What's
going on?
He claims to be the king of the Jews.
Bow before Caiaphas, the high priest.
And what have we here?
This is that one they call Jesus.
This pitiful creature is Jesus of Nazareth. Where are your adoring crowds now, Jesus? Look around you. You have no friends here. It would be a pitiful joke if he weren't so dangerous. But we know how to deal with false prophets. I need witnesses to please step forward. Witnesses. Yes.
He claims to be the Messiah.
Messiah, king. King of the Jews. Jesus, what do you say?
Doesn't look like much of a king.
Nothing to say? Well, let's see if other witnesses can step forward.
He heals on the Sabbath, and that's wrong.
Yes, breaking the Sabbath. Commandments. it. Feel nothing.
He practices witchcraft and commands demons.
Ah, those miracles. Were those done by demons? Still says nothing. I have charges and I need witnesses.
Those who had arrested Jesus brought him before Caiaphas, the high priest. The chief priests were looking for evidence against Jesus so they could put him to death. Well, they did not find any. Many false witnesses came forward. Jesus remained silent in the face of these accusations.
This is getting us nowhere. Wait, Jesus, I charge you by the living God. Tell us, are you the Christ, the Son of God?
I am.
Wait.
And you will see me sitting at the right hand of power, coming with the clouds of heaven.
I think not. Why do we need witnesses? You have heard this blasphemy with your own ears.
You've all heard it.
What must be your decision?
He must die.
The leaders condemned Jesus because he claimed to be the Son of God. Yet for us, it's proof how much he loves us. Condemn him? No. We love him and worship him as God in human form.
He's innocent. Let him go.
One of his disciples. His followers will be easy to kill. We need the master first.
Although Peter had run away with the other disciples, when Jesus had been arrested in Gethsemane, he timidly followed behind and even entered the courtyard outside the high priest's palace. Proud Peter had boldly declared that he would never deny Jesus, even if everyone else did. But Jesus had warned Peter that before the rooster crowed, he would deny him three times. Jesus had also warned Peter and the disciples to watch and pray while they had been in the Garden of Gethsemane. But there, of course, they had fallen asleep. But now Peter was in the courtyard when a servant girl approached him.
You are a disciple of Jesus.
Not me. I don't know the man.
Soon someone else said to him,
"You. You also are one of them."
I said, "I do not know the man. Go away."
Sometime later, a member of the crowd approached Peter.
"Certainly you're one of them. You're a Galilean and your speech betrays you."
"Woman, I don't know the man."
"He's lying. You're Peter." "What is that?"
But then Peter remembered what Jesus had said. "Before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times." And Peter went outside and wept bitterly.
"Oh, Lord, what have I done?"
"Who's he praying to?"
But at times, can't we be just like Peter when the times get tough? We deny Jesus or deny that we even know him?
Him to his enemies. Judas felt as though his sin was too great to be forgiven. And yet, when we sin against Jesus, can we recognize that he loves us and he wants to help restore us to God's favor and he wants to forgive us?
Nothing but a liar.
He should be taken away.
Nothing but lies.
Yeah, right.
Lies.
Jesus was taken before the Roman governor, Pontius Pilate, who recognized his innocence and sought to release him. His wife warned him that she had been troubled by a dream which told her of Jesus' innocence. The crowd, however, threatened to riot if they did not condemn Jesus as they demanded.
Then what shall I do with this man, Jesus, who you call the Christ?
Crucify him!
Crucify him!
In an effort to make the crowd feel sorry for Jesus and stop demanding his death, they ordered Jesus scourged.
Guards, scourge him.
He should be scourged.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
More than that?
Behold the man.
Crucify him! Crucify him! You let this man go. You're no friend of Caesar's.
It was a custom at the feast to release a prisoner whom the people requested. A murderer named Barabbas was in prison.
Guard, bring out Barabbas.
Barabbas!
Me to release to you the King of the Jews?
Yes, and freedom!
Yes. I'm free!
When Pilate saw that he could not convince the crowd and that a riot was about to start, he gave in to their demands.
I am innocent of this man's blood. Let it be your responsibility.
Let his blood be on us and on our children.
Pilate then turned Jesus over to the soldiers in the crowd to be crucified. They wove a crown of thorns and they placed it on his head.
He doesn't deserve
it. He's not a king. The Jews!
They spit on him and they slapped him and they led him to the place called Golgotha, the place of the skull. And there they nailed him to the cross.
Come on,
kid.
Pick up that cross.
Yeah, come on, kid. Pick the cross up.
Let's go. One way to go. Come on,
kid.
Let's go.
Come on, kid.
Come on.
Come on, kid.
We cannot just blame the Romans and Jewish leaders for what has happened. Do we realize that by our sins, we also contribute to Jesus' sufferings and death? He died for all, Scripture tells us. And do we have the courage to stand up for him and confess him, even when it is not popular?
Thank you.
Are we honest enough to admit that we nailed him to the cross by our own sins? Can we accept his gracious words of forgiveness and believe that he has restored us to God's favor? Our sins nailed his hands to the cross. The same hands that reach out to embrace us in love and mercy.
King of the Jews? Just for a short little while.
Jesus. Long.
Dear woman, here's your son. Here's your mother. That's long enough. You better keep going.
There were two thieves that were crucified alongside of Jesus. One of the thieves threw insults at him.
If you truly are the Son of God, save yourself and us.
The other thief defended Jesus.
Today, you will be with me in paradise. Paradise. I don't think so.
Guard, what shall we do with this man's robe?
Let's cast lots for it. He won't need it where he's going. The robe is mine.
From the sixth hour to the ninth hour, darkness came across the entire land. And during Jesus' crucifixion, there were seven final sayings that he spoke, all ending with,
"It is finished."
And then he cried out in a loud voice,
"Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
Guard, who is this man talking to?
You must think that God is going to come down here and save us.
Jesus, what have they done?
And then he died. At that very moment, the earth shook. Rocks were split in half. Even the curtain in the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. There was a centurion who was standing near Jesus, and even he cried out,
"Truly, this man was the Son of God."
Yes, he was.
Scripture tells us that God so loved the world, he sent his only begotten Son to die for us, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. This is the true meaning of Jesus' passion, is that God died, Jesus died, for you and for me, that we might be forgiven and be restored as children of God.
Of the passion history, but not of the story. Jesus' followers placed his lifeless body in a nearby tomb belonging to one of them, Joseph of Arimathea, where he remained under Roman guard until early Sunday morning. Our salvation was now complete, but God had one more surprise up his sleeve to give us confidence and hope. We celebrate it with all Christians on Easter Sunday. If you would like to share in our celebration, We invite you to be with us in our services at 6:30 and 10:30 to hear the rest of the story. We, the members of St. Michael's Lutheran Church of Richville, thank you for joining us on this journey and hope and pray you realize better how much God loves you and the price Jesus paid to restore you as his child. We wish you a blessed Easter.